following Sound of the Day on Wednesdays, we catch up with Tom Moores, the head coach of the Quinnipiac Bobcats men's basketball program. And I think you could say it, Coach, coming off the biggest win easily, I think, in school history, when you talk about beating an A-10 opponent in Rhode Island, a club that could wind up in the NCAA tournament this year.
Yeah, it was a great day for us Saturday, Jay. I know you were there, and we got a chance to catch up a little bit briefly after the game, too, as well. And it was a really good day for us. It was sort of a historic day, I guess, in some sense, because, like you said, we've never beaten an Atlantic 10 team. And, you know, to beat URI at our place in front of a, you know, real spirited crowd with about 3,000 people, have it also be on NESN and have it be regionally broadcast was a really good day, and made for a happy team and happy athletic administration and happy coaching staff.
You know, it looked like you were waiting for that moment, and you talked about in the post-game press conference that your players were almost waiting for that moment, maybe where URI turns it on and shows why they're an A-10 team and one of the better A-10 teams at that, and they were going to make this run somewhere in the game that maybe puts you guys away, and it just never seemed to happen. Your team always seemed to bounce back. Even when you got down four, that was one of those moments where you said, all right, this might be where Rhode Island starts to assert themselves. And then your team goes on, I think, a 12-0 run at that point, if I'm not mistaken. What did you see in your players' eyes that might have been different than other times you've been in this sort of a situation against an A-10 opponent?
Yeah, it was a 12-0 run, and there was a calmness and a confidence about our team all day, Jason, that I really liked. I mean, you can really feel it coming in and out of huddles and timeouts and stuff with your team, whether you can really get a feel for the pulse of where they are mentally pretty much every game. If it's really good or really unfocused or really nervous or really scared or overwhelmed, whatever it may be. And, you know, like I think back to that Robert Morris game, and we could never shake sort of the nerves of playing in front of that big an atmosphere, in front of that, with that much at stake, with an NCAA tournament bit at stake, and when we hosted the championship game last year. But there was a calmness and a confidence about our guys pretty much all game, and I think, you know, it was neat to be able to play from ahead most of the game. We had about a 4-5, 3-point lead, something, almost the whole game. And we never seemed to get rattled on the defensive end or the offensive end whenever anything bad happened to us. And I'm hoping it's a permanent sign of growth. It's certainly the best we've played from a confidence point of view all season. The older guys, you expect it out of us, but you don't sometimes expect it out of the younger guys. But, you know, the growth of our sophomores, in particular Jamie Jackson and Dave Johnson, and the freshmen who all played. You know, Lance Brown is a sophomore transfer, but Dominique Langston was terrific, and Ike Azatam, when they were in there, they were terrific, and they were contributing, they were making hustle plays, strong plays. So we pretty much, I said in the press conference afterwards, it's very rare that you can look up and down your team and not feel that, you know, not be disappointed with at least one or two guys that they didn't play well that day. But everybody who wore a Quinnipiac uniform Saturday contributed in some way, and it was refreshing to see.
You mentioned Dominique Langston. This is the first extended look I've gotten to him. This kid can play. I mean, he can get up above. I'm not telling you anything, you know. He could get up above the rim. He made a few plays in this game that you'll just look at the box score and see his contribution in the game. But he made a few huge plays in this game. You know, tip-ins, couple of buckets. He is a high-energy guy. That's the sort of player I can't imagine a lot of teams in your conference having somebody that of that kind of stature on your team. And I'm not saying he's the best player in the league by any stretch, but he's a guy from an energy standpoint, an athleticism standpoint, a good basketball acumen standpoint, instinctive abilities. There aren't a lot of guys like that.
Yeah, I agree, Jason. He's got a lot of talent. He's a really solid young guy, a product of Colby Cathedral High School down in Bridgeport, the prep the year under Jerry Quinn at St. Thomas More, and one of the best prep school coaches in the country. And I like to say really got his nose toughened a year ago. I think there was a lot of sort of immaturity in his game and looseness in his game. And I think Jerry knocked a lot of that out of him last year. He had to play at a higher level against every day in practice and with guys and against the schedule they play, you know, he gets tested every day, and he's got a lot of ability. He like you said, he fills a stat sheet. He can steal the ball, passes the ball well. He's got very good vision. He's turned into a fantastic rebounder for a kid about 6'2", 6'3". He's really taken to our whole, program's philosophy of rebounding, and he's been big on the defensive glass and really big on the offensive glass. You made reference to he made a huge offensive putback of his own miss at a key time in the game. He's got a confidence and a swagger about him, too, for a freshman that's pretty impressive as well. So he's got a bright, bright future, and, yeah, we're excited to have him.
You know, I ask this of every coach that I've talked to this time of year. I just asked it of Howie yesterday, and he seemed to almost welcome the fact that this is the case. You got 11 days off in between games. Do you like where the break is coming right now for this team?
From a physical point of view, yeah, we got a couple guys with little things that they need to have rested and stuff. But from an emotional point of view, as you can imagine, off those, the win Saturday, and we beat some decent teams before that too as well. The close game with UMass, but beating Lehigh and beating Maine and Mount St. Mary's and stuff. We feel like I sort of wish we could keep playing. I wish we were a little bit on an NBA schedule right now because I'd like to bottle up some of that confidence and some of that. That poise that we had Saturday, you almost like to take that out of a bottle and, play again Monday night, play again Wednesday night, that type of thing, because it was a neat thing to experience on the bench. But, we'll take it, and anytime I think you can get a break like this, it's good to tighten up some things you're not doing well and rest some guys, and that's what we're trying to do. And we play Niagara on the 22nd, and we're hopeful we'll be back into a routine of playing well when we get ready to play them.
You know, a couple of years ago, you'd need Justin Ruddy to go double-double to win a lot of nights. And even last year, there were plenty of nights where you needed that sort of effort out of Justin. The beauty of this team right now is there is so much talent here and enough spots where you could get scoring, enough guys that could give you 12 to 15 points in any given game. It's got to be nice that you don't have to lean so heavily on Justin, and you have to like the fact that that means he's going to be fresher later in the season.
Yeah, definitely. I always say when I think about this and when I talk to you, you've brought this up before and stuff, but we'd like to, in an ideal world, get him less minutes so that he does have less wear and tear. Right now we're doing it in practice to try to save Justin for the season, but we do have this is the most quality depth we've had in my 4 years at Quinnipiac. We haven't, knock on wood, we haven't really been injured, and we're bringing back Lance Brown, who missed a couple weeks with a strained groin. He got a chance to play in the Rhode Island game, and Tevin Baskin will finally make his debut in the Niagara game, and he starts practice on Saturday. So we now have, we got 12 scholarship guys that are healthy that we think are all pretty good. We can go and practice 6-on-6, basically, and really have a high-level competitive scrimmage. When we had that rough year 2 years ago where we were down to six scholarship guys, I used to always say I didn't worry as much on game nights as I would leave with an empty feeling coming out of practice because, I knew we weren't getting better and I knew we weren't competing against each other. There just wasn't enough there to compete against each other, so we got better in practice. We had some terrific, terrific battles in practice every day, and I know the carryover is coming in games, so I'm pleased with where we are from a depth point of view.
I was over at Hartford Hawks practice on yesterday, as a matter of fact, I was over at Hartford Hawks practice with visiting with John Gallagher, who I think is going to be a great young up and coming coach. I think he has all the abilities and the right attitude to turn around that program. But he said something. We were talking about your team, and he said there's no doubt in his mind your team. Not only does he think you can make the NCAA tournament, he thinks you can win a game. When you look at this team 9 games in, is there something so special here that makes you believe not only can we get in, but we can win a game? Is your team good enough to do that? Especially off what you see against Rhode Island.
Yeah, I mean, I hope, Jason, that a lot of things, I think as coaches you get paid to worry about what could go wrong with your team, and I appreciate the kind thoughts and words from John, but I hope we're in the situation where we can discuss this a week or two before the NCAA tournament, where we're in a situation where it's still question. You know, as coaches, you're always worried about if a couple, you know, things, adversity hits us in a couple different ways, are we equipped to handle that and still play well through January and February? There's so much time before we get to that point. But I will tell you, you know, when you win a game against a team above you in the manner in which we want it, it does make you feel as a coach that, like, hey, this would be exciting if we get into a situation again in a postseason tournament like that, whether it be the NIT or the NCAA, where we could say, you know, you've played URI and you were very poised and you played them equal. And, you know, almost the same thing with UMass. I think we only played really one – we played one bad half that night and one great half in the second half. But it does, as a head coach, it makes you think that, you know, we've done it once. You know, we'll be tested in our league, too, obviously, as well. When we go to play Coach D at Central, that place will be loud. And when we go down to LIU, that'll be loud. We don't go to Robert Morris this year. They come to us. But, you know, there'll be games on the road this year where we'll be tested and we'll be hunted. And it'll be interesting to see if we have the same poise and the same calmness and the same confidence as we showed the other night. That was the most, you know, against a high-level team, that was the best we've played and the calmest we've played in any single game in a big spot in my time there. So, yeah, you're hopeful that could show again. And the next time it would be that big an opponent, name-wise anyway, it would be an NCAA tournament or an NIT tournament.
Great stuff. Tom Moore, 11 days off in between games. Then you got Niagara and BU on the road. Best of luck, my friend. We'll talk to you next week.
Sounds good, Jason. Thank you.